r/AskReddit. What's the most ducked up thing the US government has done? The Trail of Tears is pretty up there for most ducked up thing. Edit. Yes, I know slavery happened. I'm not arguing that this was worse, I just named the first thing that popped into my head. Sandy Creek Massacre? 500 Colorado cavalry were sent to track down natives that were attacking settlers. For good reason, but that is a long story. They ended up coming to a Cheyenne village that was known to be peaceful. Its leader, Black Kettle, was a voice of peace for the natives and had even gone to Washington DC to meet with President Lincoln and negotiate a lasting peace between Americans and Cheyenne. Lincoln gave him an American flag and told him that so long as it flew in their camp, no American would harm them. Anyways, this a-hole Chivington was leading the cavalry, and saw it as some kind of noble duty. After months of searching for aggressive natives and coming up empty-handed, the government ordered him to disband his force and go home. Chivington, now faced with the prospect of his crusade being an embarrassment, decided to attack Black Kettle's village, basically just to say he did something. The Colorado cavalry attacked in the middle of the night in mid-November, while everyone was sleeping. Eyewitness accounts are terrifying, and basically women, children, and men were run down as they tried desperately to flee across a frozen river. Black Kettle ran into the middle of the battle waving the American flag and screaming that they were friends of America, but the Americans turned on him and he was forced to drop the flag and flee as well. The fact that Black Kettle survived is miraculous, but most of his clan did not. And the few that survived the battle mostly died of hypothermia and starvation from literally fleeing through a frozen river in the middle of the night. Cavalrymen raped live and dead women, including children, and cut off male and female genitals and strapped them to their horses as decorations. Black Kettle and what remained of his clan ended up getting sent to a reservation, where they mostly starved to death. And Black Kettle gave up on peace as the younger generation flocked to warlords like Roman Nose and Crazy Horse. This ended up contributing to Red Cloud's war, as did most of the other atrocities in the West. Oh. Also, Chivington was known to have said, "Nits make lice," a statement that referred to his campaign of exterminating native children along with everyone else. Oh, and I'm already sure Colorado nearly elected him governor after all of this anyways. I mean, there was the time the National Guard shot and killed coal miners and their families who were being horribly exploited by coal companies, so they were striking. See also, the Ludlow Massacre, and the time they decided to routinely sterilize Native American women, and the Guatemala syphilis experiments. The silencing, embarrassing, and killing of Gary Webb. Gary Webb was an investigative journalist who proved that the CIA was selling massive amounts of drugs, particularly cocaine, to typically black, poor neighborhoods all over the US. This was in order to fund an overthrow of the Nicaraguan government by US-friendly terrorists during the 90s. He was forced to resign, disgraced, blacklisted, divorced, and found dead with two bullets through his head in 2004. It was ruled a suicide despite the facts he owned no guns, and it being two bullets through the head in a suicide. The Tuskegee Syphilis Experiment. I worked in a library years ago, and while I was putting books back, I read a spine with an interesting title. I picked up the book and started reading it. That is how I found out about Tuskegee. It was never mentioned in school. If I hadn't been reading spines, I literally wouldn't even know it was a thing. Well, this probably isn't the worst thing America has done since it didn't happen, but Operation Northwoods. This was a proposed false flag attack on US soil that would justify going to war with Cuba. It was rejected by Kennedy, but approved by every man before him. It's stuff like this that makes the whole 9/11 inside job conspiracy sound a little less wacky, because this was essentially the same thing. The CIA testing birth control on unsuspecting women in Puerto Rico. I'm sure that for every ducked up thing we know about, there are even worse things that we don't. Roswell, 1947. Let's say that myth about aliens anally probing us is purely projection. The things they haven't been caught for. The MKUltra stuff they leaked was the stuff that didn't work. Agent Orange. Depleted uranium arms that polluted battlefields, people's homelands, and left generations of people with birth defects after the war was done. Beyond Agent Orange in and of itself, but even our own soldiers being told that it was relatively safe when the higher-ups knew it wasn't. I had a good friend who struggled with two cancers and a chronic respiratory issue for 30 years before succumbing to it about this time last year due to handling that stuff during Vietnam. We overthrew a democratically elected government in Iran when the people didn't vote for who we wanted. Edit. Down with the military-industrial complex. Great nations don't fight endless wars. Shouldn't you list all the democratically elected leaders we've overthrown? Operation Wetback. Along the lines, same ethics of the Japanese internment camps, but not as well known. The government has been trying to take away all the privacy. And nobody actually cares. Anytime I bring things like this up, I get treated like a tinfoil hat guy. I have also heard people parrot, if you have nothing to hide, you have nothing to fear. That attitude is dangerous. MKUltra. Staging coups on democratic governments because they had oppositional ideologies. There is literally an entire wiki page on US staged coups, allowing one of its own town's water supply to be poisoned for financial benefit, appointing family to senior government positions, Agent Orange, declaring war on a nation based on a false pretense of fighting terror, while doing nothing to the actual country that orchestrated the attack, at the same time, dragging other nations into this war and tearing relations with them, for example, France, who you would not exist without, because they didn't want to be involved, and then causing such instability that massive terrorist organizations blossomed out of it, then patting yourselves on the back for fixing a problem that the US started in the first place, except the issue is not even 100% fixed. Refusal to condemn terrorism from a particular viewpoint in order to protect your voter base. Denying their own citizens accessible healthcare, claiming it as something only people lucky or wealthy enough should have. But making weapons considered a basic right. Smallpox blankets. Literally having a civil war over slavery and being one of the last Western nations to make it unlawful. Or systematic racial segregation to the point of drinking fountains. Buses. Laundromats not even allowing them to walk through the same door, while simultaneously denying that this may have had a negative effect on huge swaths of these groups on a socio-economic level well into modern times, while also denying ongoing racism despite the fact that a huge chunk of the modern population was alive and well during those times of segregation, and had no issue with it, allowing large corporations to legally bribe politicians for outcomes that are unhealthy for the nation as a whole. Systematic pedophilia in the entertainment and business industries, and probably a lot more that was just not discovered yet, allowing a media organization to publish and broadcast false information because the organization won with an argument claiming that their news was for entertainment and not for being factual, and making shit up was more entertaining to the audiences. IDK, maybe some other shit. Some details may be wrong, but I'll find links in the morning. Edit. Apparently smallpox blankets was a lie. I retract that statement. Sent me a letter telling me that I had figured my taxes wrong. If they knew, why didn't they just do it for me? You want this chronological or alphabetical? Honestly, there's so many grotesquely ducked up things it's hard to pick just one. Not to mention there's so much that's classified that honestly we don't know for sure. The thread is bound to mention stuff like slavery, Tuskegee, MKUltra, Trail of Tears, Iran-Contra, Jim Crow laws, Vietnam War, voter suppression, Operation Northwoods, the Patriot Act, pretending COVID is a hoax to short stock, bombing Hiroshima and Nagasaki, executing mentally disabled criminals, and the list just goes on and on and on. How do you pick a most ducked up thing? I'm gonna go with not doing anything to stop the brutal lynching, rape and murder of African Americans up until the 60s. The Diego Garcia incident in the 1968, which is also one of the worst things the UK government has done. For the UK to continue purchasing nuclear missiles from America, they asked to rent out the British island of Diego Garcia in the Indian Ocean to use as a naval base. The UK then subsequently sent soldiers onto the island, forced all of the inhabitants off of the island, killed anybody who resisted, destroyed all homes and killed all the animals so US soldiers could then turn the island into a naval base. Any ex-inhabitants who tried to speak out about the incident were immediately silenced and punished, and the details of the incident were only recently made public. The island is still a joint UK's naval base to this day. hard to rank them, but the Gulf of Tonkin incident was a US false flag operation to establish the pretext to invade Vietnam to stop the spread of communism, leading to the absolutely useless deaths of millions of military and civilians, only to have the US pull out and cede control of the entire country to communist control. The most ducked up thing about it is that our government knew it was an unwinnable war, but we stayed there anyway, throwing more bodies on the pile. The news media kept a daily running count of US dead. The US govt measured success in term of number of enemy dead. I think the CIA raping and torturing US citizens is up there. They also imported and distributed drugs to black and Mexican neighborhoods. The tests they did on people are known as MKUltra, I'm pretty sure. The government also made an agreement with Japan to not hold them accountable for their crimes against humanity if Japan gave the US the results of their horrible experiments. Japan raped and tortured their own citizens, but the level of cruelty was beyond imagination. It's surgeries done without anesthesia. Weapons testing on live subjects. Dipping someone's limbs into nitrogen oxide and smashing it while they were awake. This was called Unit 731. Many presidents have ordered the military to commit crimes against humanity too. Obama ordered a drone and airstrike on a hospital full of innocent people, and so many people died. If there's worse than that, I'm not sure I want to know. The 9/11 shit is conspiracy as far as I know. Not something concrete. Edit. If you don't believe what I say, you can look it up, but here are some sources. On CIA raping innocent Americans. The program engaged in many illegal activities. 7, 8, 9. Including the use of US and Canadian citizens as its unwitting test subjects, which led to controversy regarding its legitimacy. 7, 10, 11, 12. MKUltra used numerous methods to manipulate its subjects' mental states and brain functions. Techniques included the covert administration of high doses of psychoactive drugs, especially LSD and other chemicals, electroshocks, 13, hypnosis, 14, 15, sensory deprivation, isolation, verbal and sexual abuse, as well as other forms of torture, 16, 17, MKUltra experiments, on CIA importing drugs. Wikipedia calls it controversial, so click on the sources and read them. See what Gary Webb has to say. Make your own conclusions. Wikisource. Hospital airstrike. On the 3rd of October 2015, a United States Air Force AC-130U gunship attacked the Kunduz Trauma Center operated by Medecins Sans Frontieres, MSF, or Doctors Without Borders, in the city of Kunduz, in the province of the same name in northern Afghanistan. It has been reported that at least 42 people were killed and over 30 were injured. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Drone strike source. Unit 731. Just read the article. The whole thing is terrible. Wiki article. Edit 2. It was an airstrike, not a drone strike. Throwing citizens in internment camps during World War II. Shuffles deck, picks card, not doing anything about the AIDS epidemic. This isn't a very fun card game. Gulf of Tonkin, and subsequently the Vietnam War. The incessant need to overthrow democratically elected socialist leaders and or assassinating them and then planting fascist dictators in their place. Victims. Salvador Allende, murdered by US-backed coup in Chile. Patrice Lumumba, assassinated by CIA and DRC. Thomas Sankara, murdered by US and French-backed coup in Burkina Faso. Jean-Bertrand Aristide, ousted by US-backed coup in Haiti. Dot. Anyone care to add to the list? There's lost more, I'm sure. Oh. And the US literally invaded the tiny island of Grenada in the Caribbean to take down a socialist government. Sad. I don't know. How about irradiating pregnant women? Minorities, hospital patients, and your own ducking allies for a starter? News car link. The Dred Scott decision. Involvement in the Vietnam War, Agent Orange, and slavery are the most ducked up that I can think of. The MKUltra LSD mind control experiments from the 1950s. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.